Hello, my name is Chris Eberl. I'm a senior solutions architect here at Amazon. And today I would like to talk to you a little bit about how to use Perfetto traces to debug your performance issues in your app. In order to level set a little bit and understand what Perfetto actually is, I want to give you a little bit of an overview. So let's start with the actual definition. It's an open source production grade stack for performance estimation and trace analysis. So there's a lot of buzzwords in them, so let's break that down. In more simple terms, it's a tool that lets you collect performance information by recording a step through in your app that can be visualized by using a web platform called Perfetto.dev. Later, we go through some theoretical knowledge on how to actually do that as part of React Native for Vega. So let's talk a little bit about tracing. What is it and how do we use it efficiently and effectively? So tracing is an effective way to narrow down bottlenecks when optimizing your app code. We already learned that. And this walkthrough will teach you how to do the following. So on the one hand, we'll look at how to actually add traces in an app.js's code. We'll record these app traces, and then we'll analyze them together by looking at them in Perfetto. So number one, do I have to add custom trace markers? No, you don't, but you should in order to narrow down the potential performance issues faster. We highly recommend doing that because just recording your app as a whole might be really tricky to look at. It is important to think about that you don't want to leave your Perfetto trace markers in your code when you release your app to production, as this can have significant performance downsides. So only use them during development and remove them afterwards. So adding traces in JS code, identifying the section of the code you want to measure using tracing is key. It is a good practice to add traces around the hottest parts of your code, for example, the ones that are executed the most or often or take the longest. For example, in a video app example, we could look at how smooth from a fluidity perspective your app performs when you navigate through a swim lane. So if you're investigating a slow focus issue that surfaces when scrolling in a flatless component that renders touchable opacity component, you can add traces around the callback function passed to unfocus prop of the touchable opacity component, so to say. By the way, systrace, which we'll use in this example, is part of the React Native API, and therefore you can use it to emit these traces. So how does that actually look in code? So we would import systrace from React Native. You've identified the function of interest, and you just place them as they're like marked on the right in your code, and therefore it would perform a trace for you from the begin event, which you can also give a name so you can easily identify it afterwards in Perfetto. So recording the app traces, luckily we provide you some of the tools. So Perfetto originally comes from the Android world, but we realized as part of like our ecosystem, we need you to give you the tools on how to record these traces as well. And I'll show you that how that works with Activity Monitor within our apps, so you have an easy access through the UI. So if I take up the example again, for a scrolling issue in OnFocus Handler with the touchable opacity, that is part of a flat list, the recording steps would look like the following. We want to launch the app, we run Activity Monitor, we start the recording, name it accordingly, we perform the scrolling within the app, and we stop the recording. And once the recording is complete, you will get trace log files, as you can see them on the right, in a generated folder as part of your app. And these are the ones that we will then use in Perfetto.dev. So now that we have them, we can actually go to the Perfetto.dev UI on the webpage and can like upload our traces and start inspecting them. Let's analyze them top to bottom. So after the trace file loads in Perfetto, which might take a while, you can find the traces you added in the code using the search bar at the top, entering the trace name. So if we narrowed it down, as I said before, it's a lot easier to just look at these events, which makes your life also tremendously simple in that regard. And once you locate the trace, analyze the duration of the trace across all occurrences and check if it is as expected. If there are traces stacked below a trace, see if the stack trace is expected as well. So you might think all of the Perfetto UI could be like very convoluted. No worries. We'll dive deeper into that a little bit later as part of this talk as well, so you get an understanding of like the full Perfetto UI as well. So without further ado, this was a lot of information to digest from a theoretical knowledge standpoint. Let's dive deep in some of these areas together as part of an actual like live demo. I prepared a little sample app here, super simple video app, couple tiles that we'll use on how to use systraces within an app in a very simple way on an on focus handler. So I will start now implementing the systrace, importing it from React Native. I already know where my function is. A little bit further down, it's this like handler right here. I'm able to do a systrace.beginEvent. So I begin the event, I give it the exact same name as we had on the slide deck for consistency. And then in the next step, I will also do the systrace.endEvent. So we have like a very short capture and understand the milliseconds essentially like consumed during that period. So it is very important that you have the systrace.end as well. Otherwise, your capture is not sufficient and you would not see it correctly in the visualization, so to say. So now we just need to like rebuild our app pretty quick. So as you can see, the app is navigatable, but now we actually need to like capture the traces, and that we can do with the activity monitor. I'll give it a name, systrace.capture. I'll start my recording. I can now use the remote, do a couple of steps in the app to trigger the capture. And as soon as I hit stop recording, it will pull it up as form of a visualization. This is all part of our Vega developer tools as well. However, you also have that like trace available now to pull it up in the actual Perfetto UI. And that is what we're going to do. So as you can see, you get a generate directory. You have the file right there. We'll open a new window in your preferred browser. We'll use a perfetto.dev. We'll go to the trace viewer. And as you can see, it's very colorful. There's a lot of stuff going on. So let's look for our event that we just captured so we can dive deep together. Here's the event. You also see the states of like running. You see the measurement right above. You can get as granular as you want with the actual event name. So I'm trying to do it as well. You see it actually is within the right JavaScript thread that we explained before. And now you can dive deep on that event. So we don't have anything else going on below that stack. That is why you don't see anything there. But if you look, for example, at the perform mounting instructions, you'll see there's like more going on there. You can analyze how long did it actually take. You can see the stack events that happen afterwards. And if we go back to the video app, and if we then actually slowly start to zoom out, you can also see the ticks that we did by jumping through the quick clicks on the remote to like do the navigation. And as we can zoom out, you see like the little spikes here on the bottom in the screen. And therefore you can identify what we did on the D-pad or like our remote, our TV remote, so to say. And as we now expand and zoom in further again, the remaining piece I wanted to show here is how you can also like measure time. So you can essentially just select anywhere on that UI of what you want to measure instead of clicking the item exactly. And this is how you can see what the time was. So let's look at the trace markers and thread breakdowns. While this overview might be overwhelming, I want to give you a little bit of ease and just look at the most important things here. So perform mounting instructions is the main UI thread, and it represents how long it took the native layer of React Native finish manipulating the host views, given a list of mutations from React renderer cycle. So let's look at that in an example. As we say, it's the most important one to look at. If we look at the pink trace mark on the thread, thread number 19 JS thread, it took us 64 milliseconds for the sports app to render its homepage. The resulting brown trace marker took 148 milliseconds to complete. This is because several new native host components needed to be created for all the new React components getting mounted. And this can be easily seen as part of this visualization. So the trace marker also represents how long it took the native layer of React Native for Vega to finish manipulating the host who has given him a list of mutations from the React render cycle, so to say. So let's look one level deeper. Still at performing mounting instructions. If the UI update is minimal, for example, the D-pad on the remote is pressed to navigate from one item to another, then the perform mounting instruction should be less than 5 milliseconds, just as a benchmark. For this exact scenario, we can see that the UI manager complete surface took 58 milliseconds to complete and the perform mounting instructions took 235 microseconds. So the next two we want to kind of look in combination. So the UI manager complete surface is also part of the JS thread, as well as the JSI executor, which like actually loads the bundle. So complete surface is a React renderer cycle, a single one. And the load bundle is how long it takes for the system to load the applications bundle to load actually. So let's look at them one by one. In the Perfetto UI, this thread often shows up as unlabeled, usually as thread number 19 or thread number 20. However, there are common trace markers that always run that make it easy to identify. These trace markers are the load bundle one and the complete surface. On the right side, you see the top to bottom breakdown on how you can look at these traces. So first you would load the app.js bundle, then the executing apps JavaScript, then lazy loading any turbo modules, any custom trace markers, React and render, and then would come like the UI events. So let's look at the indication of how long it takes for the system to load the applications bundle. So as you can see, you see the JSI executor bundle right there in green. We also see it occurred as part of like thread number 19. In this case, that is the JS thread we want to look at. And it took a total of 70 milliseconds to load. If we look at complete surface, each of these represents actually a single React render transaction or cycle. So the duration of these trace markers are typically directly correlated to its child trace marker, root shadow node layout, which indicates how long the layout calculations took, for example. So if I look at the UI manage complete surface, it took around 58 milliseconds total versus its child. The root shadow node layout took 44 milliseconds on its own, roughly 75% of the total duration. So while all of these amounts right now seem pretty low because we're looking at a pretty well-managed app actually, but if you would be looking at your app where you're like expecting performance issues, you might see a lot larger amounts of milliseconds, and these are then the areas you want to start investigating on. So a little bit more to learn, like depending on I/O and CPU and memory availability, can be in one of multiple states. So for example, the sleeping one is the most common one. The thread is waiting for an event, for example, a timer, a mutex, or a resource, but can be interrupted by a signal or an event. In the Perfetto UI, the thread state is unlabeled in that regard. If we look at runnable, the thread is ready to run, but is not currently executing because the CPU is running in another thread. It is waiting in the scheduler queue for CPU time. In Perfetto UI, the thread state will show as a lighter green labeled as a runnable. If they're runnable but preempted, the thread was running but preempted, interrupted by the scheduler to let another thread run. This can happen due to higher priority tasks or time slice expiration in multitasking systems. In the Perfetto UI, the thread state will be as a lighter green labeled runnable preempted. The thread is currently executing on the CPU and is actively using CPU cycles when the thread state is actually running. In the Perfetto UI, the thread state will show as dark green and labeled as running. And if something is uninterruptible sleep or uninterruptible sleeping, the thread is waiting on an event that cannot be interrupted. For example, it's waiting for I/O operations like disk access or hardware responses. And this is typically seen when the thread is blocked. So essentially in the Perfetto UI, the thread state will show us as a light orange labeled as uninterruptible sleep. I wanted to thank you for watching today. And I hope these app performance talks are really pushing your knowledge and helping you making more performant apps for Amazon.